Hi everybody and welcome back to my basement once again. Today I have a package from Vita FPV. But before I open this box, please remember to like, subscribe and comment on this video. Help me, please, the algorithm. Can I say it faster? I don't think so. So, let's go. I have to admit, I am guilty and I already checked what's in the box. So, I know we have three new products from Vita FPV. Let's open it and I'll show you them right now. So, I'm only gonna review one today. So, we have the new Express LRS Micro TX module, this bad boy right here. We're gonna use it today, but I will not make a review of it today. We need it to use what's inside the box. Then we have their new 2.4 GHz Express LRS, super tiny receiver with the antenna soldered SMD. This will be amazing for hoops and for lightweight stuff. I guess it's less than 1 gram. This we'll review together with the radio next time. But today, the star of the show is this beautiful box right here. Vita FPV, wow, they stepped up their game. And inside here we have the Meteor 65, as you can see. Super nice color. I like this pastel green. It's so tiny. Today is a lot of tiny stuff, actually. This will be great for winters. And just take a look at this beautiful box right here. It also has the Vita FPV branding on the zipper right here. It feels very premium. I love it. So let's open it and see what's inside. Gonna open it sideways like this. So let's start from the accessories. We get a USB-C cable, very thick one. I love it. Nice when they include this. Then we have this little thing. I'm gonna show you later how it works. Basically, this thing is a dual battery charger and tester that goes together with the USB-C cable. Love it. A little screwdriver right here. A spare set of Vita FPV 35mm propellers. Very nice. And lastly, a QR code with the instructions. And right here we have the drone itself, but if you remove it, you can see there is other stuff on the bottom. So basically it's a foam padding with a couple of LiPos. And I really like these LiPos. They are Vita FPV branded 300mAh 1S. And they reuse their new connector, the BT2.0. Very nice. This is supposed to give you more juice on your tiny whoops. Look how tiny this is. It's crazy. Let's talk about specs. So we have a 65mm motor-to-motor, 21g drone, 35mm propeller, 19,000 kV, 0802 motor. They're super small, but actually they feel notchy. I like them. And it has a F4 flight controller, 5 amp ESC, and it has an integrated Express LRS 2.4 receiver. I'm gonna show you later. It's soldered into the SMD, very nice. We have a Vita FPV micro camera with a 350, actually it's a lot for a drone this small, milliwatt VTX. And I guess this thing is gonna have some pretty good range as well. Let's open it so I can show you the insides. And here you can see the insides. Here we have the camera, the VTX, and here these little components right here is the little 2.4 GHz antenna. Super small, but with Express LRS should have no problem with range at all. So let's close it and let's go fly. And before I go and fly, I want to show you this little battery charger. It's super nice because it has the USB-C connection on one side and two ports. One is written test on it. What happens is if you flip it and you connect one battery only on the test, look at this. It shows you the actual voltage of your battery. It's super nice because you can always test which one is full and which one is empty. And if you connect two of them, when you plug the USB-C, it goes into charging mode. And I know you cannot see it, but there are two red lights here. They will turn green when your batteries are full. And actually, they charge in about 10 minutes, which is incredible. And it's finally time to fly. Today we are indoors because this is an indoor drone after all. So I'm gonna fly a bit out and a bit inside. And I whipped out my old Taranis radio. Who remembers this one? But today with the Express LRS thingy. Boom. Look at the colors. It's super nice, this module. I'm gonna review in another episode. It makes so little noise, it's crazy. It's super cute actually. So, let's go. And you will excuse me for my goggles noise, but I don't know why. Probably it's empty the battery, I don't know. So, let's fly. Whoa. Makes a really bad noise. but it's gone. Yeah, cause the frame is very flexible actually. But if you fly a bit, it fixes itself as you can. Oh, it's so fast! It's so hard to control actually, because the camera is tilted way up. Oh my god. Oh my god. Acro maybe. I don't know, it's a very aggressive acro. Look! Oh! Wow! It's super fun to fly because it's so puny and tiny, it doesn't make any noise. And you can see, I'm indoors and I'm flying outdoors. The VTX is holding out phenomenally, I would say. Wow! Let me put... It's almost uncontrollable, I don't know. I'm not used to this radio anyway. So, okay, angle mode, much better. Much, much better. Okay, now we are in control of the situation. I have this basement, it's full of chairs, and soon I'm gonna try flying through them, but I'm not used to this radio, and the camera angle is a little... And the camera angle is a little bit high, and don't mind of the mess. We had parties, we had stuff, it's full of balloons, of Halloween thingies, pumpkins, you can see. Wow. And it's very hard to concentrate while talking in English. I mean, it's very fun to fly like this. And it flies amazing, I have to say. Look, this is outside, there is no wind today, but it's flying. Wow, amazing. And... the thing with this drone is, of course, it's made to be flown indoors. And what I'm seeing is this camera has a little bit too much fisheye, in my opinion. You can see when I tilt, all the room shifts, you can see. It's weird. And it's hard to judge dimensions when it shifts like this. I'm gonna go outside to show you this more properly. You see how everything stretches when I rotate the camera? Yeah, I wish the camera was a little bit narrow angle and maybe a little bit less angle, because... I mean, if you're racing, no problem, but... it's quite oval lot. Oh my god. Oh! Whoa! But this fisheye lets you, I mean, it feels faster with the fisheye, you know what I'm talking about. Everything seems to be flowing faster. The battery is drained, let's land. And we flew for 3 minutes, which is amazing for a 1S drone. And we actually kind of pushed it, no problem on the motor side. For indoor, it's a ton of fun, and for outdoor, too. And now, time to fly outside. I will try some acro with the trees back there, maybe follow some cat. Let's go. Perfect, it's recording, let's go. And it's on my leg, actually, so... that's the beauty of small drones. So silent. Yeah, this is amazing, not only for indoors, but also... if you, I don't know, if you fly in a small park when where people don't really like drones, this is a very nice... oh! Wow! This is a very nice drone to fly, except the camera kind of sucks outside, because I cannot really see clear. Oh, oh my god. Yeah. Oh! 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 Yeah. So lazy. Yeah, I have to stand up. So I was telling you before crashing, you cannot really see much against the sun, and I don't think it flies very good acro, because you see, if you dive, it goes totally in washout. So yeah, better to keep it for indoors. And maybe fly angle, because you see, it flies good.
He can fly acro, but he's not super, super precise. Outside, at least. I've not tried inside. Come on, there is no cat around when I need it. Not one. I mean, the VTX is perfect, though. Like, it flies, it works perfect. No interferences, it's amazing. And you can see inside, you can see clearly everything, and much, much better. It seems very sensitive to low light, but not that much sensitive to, you see, the dynamic range is not really the best on this camera. That's the only thing I will change on this drone, I think, because everything else is fine. I mean, I don't expect this drone to fly acro or anything like that. But if you wanna take a stroll in the park, fly a bee basically, because this is the size of a bee, very big bee. But low battery, yeah. Let's land.
Final thoughts about the Beta FPV Meteor 65 Pro Express LRS Edition. So this little drone, of course, is a 65mm whoop, and for this size it does a lot, actually, because I tried other ones. I guess this is the Mobula 6, and it has bigger props, as you can see, 35mm props, and it shows. In fact, you can fly indoor, but also a bit outdoor, and don't expect to do much acro with it. You can flip and it can roll, but that's about it. If you try to dive, it goes into prop wash, but at this size it's just like a leaf in the wind, and it needs more weight to do that kind of stuff. But it flies very, very good and fast anyways, and also it's quite efficient, because the propeller again are a little bit bigger, and it quite shows in the battery life. If you push it 3 minutes, if you go slower, probably can do 4 or 5 minutes, which is a lot on 1S. And still, it's as light as this one with the smaller props. Very, very nice. Also, the frame looks quite durable. It's super, super thin and narrow, and it flexes a lot, which is good for this size of drone. It means when you crash, it's gonna deflect and absorb the impact. So I guess it's quite durable as well. Today I crashed a bit, and no problem at all for now. And as far as signal goes, this is one of the best in its class. In fact, Express LRS just gives you a lot of range, and the VTX is perfect. 350 milliwatts on this little drone. You saw it, the signal was very, very good. No breakups, no nothing. And it's very good if you want to fly in a park with this, or in a big house, where with these kind of drones, I started to have breakups when I went into other rooms, and even fail safes. So with this one, you should not have these issues. Wrapping up, this Tiny Whoop is one of the best in its class for flight performance, efficiency, and signal. It only misses one spot to be the best absolute 65mm in my opinion, and it's the camera and camera mount, actually, because camera is fine enough indoor. Like, you can navigate, of course, it doesn't have a big flow. I just would prefer something with more dynamic range to see more when, you know, there is a window or something, because if you go outside, you're blinded by the light, not just like the weekend, but all week basically with this thing. And it's the sun is setting right now, and I really found hard to fly with this. And maybe I'm spoiled by digital cameras, but I remember analog being a little bit better. And probably the Mobula 6 had a better camera. Not only a better camera, but they did a mount that could swivel up and down. So when you are indoors, you can fly at, I don't know, 5 degrees, go very slow and have a better time. When you are outside, you can point it like this and fly really, really fast. And I know the company Beta FPV, and they often go form over function. And this drone actually looks very nice. It looks like it was designed from Apple. I don't know. It looks like an iMac, the new ones. I'm gonna show you a pic to know what I mean. But yeah, I guess they didn't want to go too elaborate on the canopy, to just look sleek. And it's a missed opportunity in my opinion, because they just could have made an oval slit, and it's much better, you know, to be able to select your camera angle. And that's all for this review. And actually, this is a little bit of history. You may not know, Bida FPV started out with Tiny Whoops, because I remember them in 2016. I was flying Tiny Whoops and I was ordering pieces from Bida FPV. They used to make like brushed motors, very, very fast. They will burn after like 1 week of use, but they were made to really, really push. And then they evolved from there, Tiny Whoops, and then they started with Cine Whoops. And then we are today, they are a full-fledged company. But this is where they started, so I guess they know how to make these drones. And I will use this drone during Christmas this year, because there is my nephew, my uncle's dog. I will chase them around with something, without feeling of crashing into them, of course, because this thing is harmless, totally harmless. And that's where it shines. Fly indoors, fly in a park where people don't want to be bothered. This is perfect. As always, thank you for watching. Remember to like, subscribe, and comment on this video. Let me know what you think about this little drone. I personally think I would like to see digital on this, like some super lightweight digital. It will be amazing. And if you need to buy something, check out the links in the description below. And as always, stay safe and happy flying. Bye.